Bless you. Praise the Lord. God bless you. My name is Minister Red, pastor of Christ Our Life Ministries, located in Augusta, Georgia, on 308 Rose Street, directly behind the Walmart Lowe's on Bobby Jones Expressway, Interstate 520 heading west. I pray that you'll join us for our worship services every Sunday at 10 a.m. and for Bible study every Thursday night at 7 p.m. I'm sure you'll be blessed, just as well as I know you'll be blessed by today's teaching on the agape love of God. The agape love of God. God ain't nothing but love. That's all God is. God ain't nothing but love. Amen. I thank God for another opportunity to come and stand before y'all tonight too. Amen. Hallelujah. I've truly missed y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. My mama's doing well. I want to thank y'all that's been praying with me for my mama. Amen. That had a little stroke, amen, and God is doing wonderful things, amen. My mama's always almost back to 100% recovery, amen. Hallelujah, amen, and she's about to get there. I will go up and see her, amen, this weekend, amen. The Lord has been, amen, putting, impressing upon my heart to anoint my mother with oil, amen, and let the anointing, amen, seal the deal. Amen, and let the anointing seal the deal, amen. Hallelujah. We serve an awesome God today. We serve an awesome God. We serve a true and living God, reigning supreme, amen, in this world that I think that a lot of people think he ain't reigning supreme in. Amen. He ain't running nothing, but he's reigning supreme. And the reason why, if he's not reigning supreme in your life, it is because you fail to keep the faith in him. Oh, he reigned supreme in Peter's life. As long as Peter kept his eyes on him. It was when Peter took his eyes off of him that the supreme reign ended. Amen. But God didn't end it. Peter ended it. Because Jesus said to him, wherefore didst you doubt in the supreme reigning word of God that I spoke to you when I said, come, amen, out of the boat and walk on the water with me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I see my audience is popping in. I ain't seen. God bless you, Brother Peachy. Amen. I sure have missed you too, my friend. Yes, I have. Pastor back. Amen. Got a mighty word for us tonight. Amen. 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 Go before the Lord with a praise and worship song. God bless you, Sister Peachy. Glad to see you too. God bless you, Gloria. Amen. Glad to be back. Moms is doing outstanding, amen. I'm telling you, that 83-year-old lady is stronger than an ox, amen. Love my mama, amen. Love my mama. You gotta know, amen. Pastor Red don't know who his daddy is. I've never met my daddy in my life. Amen. Hallelujah. And I don't think that I ever will, amen. If my mama's 83, I'm pretty sure my dad is that age, if not older. Amen. Might be gone already, but I still got my mama, amen. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. We thank him tonight. We thank him tonight for parents. We who still have parents in the land of the living, because I know a lot of people whose parents are no longer here in the land of the living. So while mine's is here, I'm going to love on her, amen. I want her to know that her son loves her. She is the apple of my eye. She is the one that raised me up. The one that, amen, as a kid, amen, that sat us, me and my brothers and my cousins, sat us down on the couch and taught us the Bible and would hit us with a switch if we didn't act like we was listening to her. Amen. I am the product of a woman that raised me up in the Lord. And she is seeing the fruit of her labor in my life for what she did to me as a kid, keeping me in church, drilling the word of God into my thought process, until I became of age and God took over. Amen. But she laid the foundation, amen, in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Let us go before the Lord with a worship song, amen, and give the other people time to join the telecast. We just want him to show us his way. Show us your way, Lord. Show us your way, Lord. God bless you, Kobe. I love you. Thank you for joining me tonight, classmate. I love you. Oh, God is good. We just want him to show us his way.
Show me your way.
Show me, Lord,
that I may walk with you. Show me your way.
Show me your way.
I put my hope in you.
Come on now.
The cry of my heart is to love you more, to live with the touch of your hand stronger each day.
Yes, Lord.
Show me your way.
That's all we got to do.
Show me your way.
You know what, Brother Peaches? So many ways right now that we can walk. Our families is going one way. Our friends is going one way. Oh, the body of believers is going one way. The world is going one way.
The cry of my heart is to love you more, to live with the touch of your,
but here we go right here,
stronger each day.
I'ma tell you,
stronger each day.
As he shows us his way, I'm stronger each day. Show me, don't do it. That I may walk. He's the only person I want to walk with. He was the only person Enoch walked with. The Bible says Enoch walked with God and was not, for God took him.
The cry of my is to you more, to live with the of your stronger each.
See, that's the problem right there. That's the problem. We ain't getting stronger each day. We ain't getting stronger each day. Yes, Lord.
Show me your way.
We ain't saying that enough. We ain't saying that enough. We're not saying that enough. All we gotta do is ask him, he'll show us.
I put my hope in you.
The cry. See, not the cry of my voice. Not the cry of my displeasure. Stronger each day.
Show me your way.
The cry of my heart is to love you the way you love me. To live with the touch of your hand. Stronger each day. Stronger each day.
Show me your way.
Stronger each day.
Stronger
each day.
Show me your way.
Say it for me again. Say it for me again.
Stronger each day.
Each day. Each day. Each day. Each day. Oh yes, Lord. Oh yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, Sister Peachy, it's time for the body of Christ to stop living sporadic. Amen. There's too much sporadic living today in the life of believers. Too much sporadic living. Oh, sporadicness is running rampant today in the lives of people that say they believers. As God is looking for dead men who will manifest everlasting love. As if we don't know what the definition of the word everlasting is. Oh, come on now. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We come boldly before your throne of grace that we may obtain mercy to find grace to help in a time of need. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, in the time of need. What do you need? What do you lack? Oh, if we'll just come boldly before his throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Lord, we need you. We need you stronger each day to show us your way. Oh, we love you today, Lord. Oh, we thank you for another opportunity to come before your presence and to hear your word. Not the words of Pastor Red, but the words of the Almighty God through the anointing, the unction of the Holy Spirit. Oh God, it might be my voice that they recognize, and it might be my face that they know. But Heavenly Father, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight and thy sight only. My strength and my redeemer. It's in the mighty name of Jesus that we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. The day is growing shorter. The day is growing shorter. The thing that never seems to grasp the concept of the human mind, the thing that seems to be missing in the mind of humanity, is the fact that we're going to die one day. And when we die, we're going to meet a God that the Bible calls love. We're going to encounter a God that the Bible calls love. And this God that the Bible calls love is currently sitting on his throne looking for dead men who will manifest his everlasting love down here on this planet. Well, the problem down here is we human beings are nothing but hatred. And to love at all times is extremely difficult. For us to love at all times is extremely difficult. Meaning if it's hard for us to love at all times, then that means we're going to have sporadic behavior. We're going to love today. We're going to hate tomorrow. We're going to love today. We're going to be disgusted tomorrow. We're going to love today. We're going to complain tomorrow. But the manifestation that God is looking for is an everlasting love manifestation. It is known as agape love. the love of God. God is love. The problem with God, is God is love. He can't be nothing else. That is all he is. He can't not be what he is not. And this piece of aluminum I got in my hand will always be aluminum. It's the nature of this stick is aluminum. It will always be aluminum. It will be everlasting aluminum. God is everlasting love, and he is believing that we who say that we are born again believers of his, he's believing that we're going to manifest that love in the face of evil, in the face of hatred. He's telling Satan about us the same way he told Satan about Job. Hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, who escheweth evil, who's upright, and that eschews evil? And the Satan says, you have. But you put a hedge about him. Oh, did you know that when you was baptized in the name of Jesus, Romans chapter 6 says, to as many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ, were baptized into his death. Did you know that when you was baptized into Jesus, the outer resurrection life of Jesus, the Christ life, became your heads? That God will not remove for Satan. Oh, you see, Job wasn't in Christ, but we are. We are in Christ. And God is not removing the heads from the believer's life. God didn't remove the heads from Peter walking on the water. Peter walked out of the hedge. I'm telling you, believers are walking out of love, because they see what God sees. God sees, and God knows that human beings are nothing but hatred. We see the hatred. The media gonna make sure we see the hatred. He's going to make sure that we react to the hatred. Jesus tells us in John 16 and 33, he tells us, in this world, ye shall have tribulation. You're going to have problems. He ain't talking to no specific race. He ain't telling you to go and start movements. He ain't telling you to go join organizations. He's telling you, in this world, you're going to have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I'm your hedge. I have overcome every level of hatred that you will experience. I have already overcome that for you. All you got to do is just stay in the ark. All you got to do is just stay in the boat. All you got to do is just stay in the faith. Let the waves hit you. Let the lightning strike you. Stay in the love of God. God can't do nothing but love. That is the problem we have with him. He will not stop loving even at the sound of the trump, even as he assigns humanity to their eternal home when he comes back here to judge the world. If he will not separate you from what you love, because he understands what love is. That's why he says, love not the world, nor the things that are in the world. For the love of the world is not of the Father. Love not the world. I know some of y'all. If Donald Trump loses the election, some of y'all gonna love that. If Donald Trump wins the election, some of y'all gonna love that. You know why? Because you spend too much time with them that are without. Colossians 4 and 5 says, walk in wisdom toward them that are without, redeeming the time. Redeeming the time that you've lost, not spending it in love. Not walking in wisdom to them without. Well, what's walking in wisdom? 1 Corinthians 1 and 30. But of him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom. Walk in Christ Jesus towards them that are without. Redeeming the time. God is looking for dead men who will manifest everlasting love, which is none other than, you know what the manifestation of everlasting love is? It is the steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the Lord. That is everlasting love. Always abounding in the, never coming out of the Christ life to entertain them that are without. Are you in Christ? Are you in wisdom? Are you in him? If you are in him, are you in him? You are? Well, shut up. Shut up. You need to shut up. Let the world do what the world gonna do. Let the world be the world. Because in the world, you're going to have tribulation. In the world, you're going to have tribulation. If you're in Christ, the world ain't touching you. Saul thought he was persecuting the church, but the Lord slapped him down and says, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? Because Saul loved the law more than he loved the wisdom of God. You understand? The wisdom of God. Paul thought he was so wise, but he didn't realize he was persecuting the wisdom of God. Those that were in the wisdom of God. Men who manifest everlasting love. Who are men who manifest everlasting love? Those who walk in wisdom towards them that are without. Let's go into these verses. The greatest thing we must come to know in life is that God is love. There is no chain. There is no power. There is no instrument strong enough that can break God's heart towards those who walk in wisdom towards them that are without. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. What you need to do, you need to take the mirror. You need to look in it. You need to be very, very honest with yourself about your love towards them that are without. You need to be very honest. You need to be very, very honest with yourself. It's time to stop being judgmental. It's time to stop thinking that you know what's right and what's wrong. It's time to stay in love. But you don't know how to stay in love. Because you just got to comment. You just got to comment. I'm gonna tell you what you say to people, what your pastor say. If you're gonna call me your pastor, I'm gonna tell you what your pastor say. They say, hey, Mr. Red, what you think about what's going on in the world? I ain't thinking about nothing going on in the world. My mind is on the Lord. Whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are good report, think on these things. I say nothing else. They leave me alone. You know what it is? Because you wanna comment. The love of God won't allow me to comment. It only allows me to speak what I spend my time in. You know, that's a shame. You spend your time reading the Word of God, studying the Word of God, listening to music that exalts God, but then when you get around them that are without, your conversation agrees. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Get your mirror and look at yourself and don't look at what I'm saying. You know very well if you are walking in wisdom towards them that are without or if you are walking in the same mindset of them that are without. Because them that are without do not know love. And those that are without, they don't know love. They do not know God, for God is love. God is pure love. And we're going to have to buckle down, get rooted and grounded in our faith, and stop being moved by every wind and doctrine, by every movement, by what's happening in this world that Jesus told us in this world, we're gonna have all types of problems. But I want you to be a good cheer because you're in me and I have overcome every last bit of that hatred. I will take 7 bullets in the back before I will take the beating that he took. I'll take it. This is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you that God is light. See, but you know what? We act like we can't see love.
I know you can. Is that love? Look, the stuff you seeing of them that are without, it does that look like love?
Then why you commenting on it? Stay in the boat. Stay in the ship. I should have put the picture up back up on there, the ark with the windows on it. See, your Christ life got too many windows in it. You got too many windows in your life. You can see out. You see out too much. I don't see out. I hear out. I don't see out. I hear out. I ain't looking at that mess. I'm not entertaining that. I'm redeeming the time. The time when I used to look at that mess, when I used to listen to that mess, when I used to walk with them that are without, with not in wisdom. But now I'm walking in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. You're not getting my time. Tonight, I'm not giving you my time to talk about worldly events. Not going to do it. Hate me all you want. Dislike me all you want. I'm walking in wisdom towards them that are without. I'm walking in love. The light God, whose love has shined his light on me. God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. Only those that are without walk in darkness. If we say that we have fellowship with love and we walk in hatred, we lie and do not the truth. If we walk in the light, in the love, as he, Christ, is in the light, in love, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sins, cleanses us from all that knowledge that we had when we walked towards them that are without, outside of wisdom. We don't want nobody to call us stupid, you know. We don't want nobody to call us dumb. We don't want nobody to call us silly. But I'm gonna tell you one thing. Some church people do dumb stuff. Church people do stupid stuff. You do stupid stuff that we get, that the manifestation of love is nowhere visible in your behavior, in your vocabulary, in your text messages, in your Facebook posts. You think God can't hear you on your talking to your friends on the cell phone? God hear you. Pastor Red don't need to hear you. Forget Pastor Red. I'm a human like you. I'm nobody. But God can hear you. Oh, he can hear you. He can see your heart. He can see that your heart ain't crying out. Stronger each day. Show me your way. Your heart, people's heart ain't crying out today for God. They're crying out for vengeance, for justice. In a world that Jesus told us that was going to be filled with a bunch of tribulation. But you can't tell some church people they ain't in the light. The reason why God is light is so that love can let you see. So that love can, because if you ain't got no light, you ain't gonna be able to see. So that love can let you see what love doesn't look like. You know what? I don't even know why. I don't know why people come to hear me teach sometime. I know people that heard me teach for years. And when I talk to them, their vocabulary has remained the same. I'm in awe at some of my pastor friends, some of the people in ministry that are still being impacted by the events taking place in today's world. And I know that these men and women of God, these professing believers, I know that they have read Colossians 4 and 5. I know they read Colossians 4 and 5. I know they read walk in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. They ain't redeeming no time. They stuck on pause. They stuck on pause in hatred. In hatred. No, it's only two now. You either in love or you in hatred. That's it. There's nothing else. You either in love or you in hatred. I'm telling you, you better get in the mirror. You better get in the mirror. Because I'm going to tell you, them people in the Bible, when Jesus told their story, and he came back here, and they's like, did we not prophesy in your name? Did we not cast out demons in your name? And Jesus said, but I say unto you, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye worker of iniquity. What is iniquity? Hatred. What is iniquity? Walking in them, walking towards them that are without, not in the life of Christ. Not in love. Everything the enemy is going to throw at you is in an attempt to get us to not walk in the everlasting love of God, who is the Christ life. We are in Jesus Christ. Hebrews 13, 8 through 9 says, Jesus Christ, the same. The same what, Pastor Red? What is he? He is the same yesterday. The yesterday before. So what is yesterday? It was the day before. Yesterday was the day before George Floyd was died. It was the day before Breonna Taylor was shot in the house. It was the day before Ahmaud Arbery was gunned down in Brunswick. It was the day before this Jacob Blake, whatever his name is, was shot in the back 7 times. He is the same yesterday that you loved people before these events took place, and today and forever. He does not change. When the world, when the tribulation of the world shows up, are you in Jesus Christ? Are you all? Well, shut up. Shut up and stay the same, because you didn't say nothing yesterday. You know why you didn't say nothing yesterday? Because the tribulation hadn't manifested. Just because tribulation manifests itself, you do not open your mouth. You continue to let everything that have breath praise the Lord. You praise him in the morning, you praise him in the noonday, you praise him in the, if you praise him, you shut your mouth. if words of love are not going to be the manifestation exiting your lips? Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm not going to talk Jesus Christ today. Somebody gonna go and kill a black person, and then tomorrow I talk about it. No, I'm gonna talk about Jesus Christ on Wednesday. I'm gonna talk about him on Thursday. I'm gonna talk about him on Friday. If you come up to me and say, "Hey, what do you think about what happened?" I don't care what happened. I'm staying in the Christ life. I'm going to let the world be exactly what Jesus told me it was going to be in John 16 and 33. I'm going to look at the tribulations that are going to occur in it. I'm not going to... See, that's what happened to Peter. That's what happened to Peter. When Peter said, "Lord, bid that I come out on the water with you." Peter got out on the water, walked with the everlasting love of God manifested in the flesh at the time. The word of God was made flesh. Love was walking on the water towards Peter. Peter said, love said, "Come, son." Tribulation happened while they was on the water, and Peter took his eye. I'm not taking my eyes off the Lord to look at nothing that's happening on CNN, MSNBC, Fox. None of them. I'm not taking my eyes off Jesus. So how I know that you've taken your eyes off Jesus is you're talking about it. Because I tell you, yesterday you was not talking about it. I want to know why you're talking about it today. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Be not carried. Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines. For it is a good thing that the heart be established in grace. Oh, y'all's heart ain't established in grace. You Republicans hate Democrats. You Democrats hate Republicans. You Republicans hate Nancy Pelosi. You Democrats hate President Trump. Y'all got hatred in your heart. But you know, but you won't acknowledge it though. You want it. You'll sit up there and you'll ignore it. And in your ability to ignore it, when the tribulation kicks in, it comes out your mouth. I hate Donald Trump. I hate Nancy Pelosi. I hate Joe Biden. I hate the Democrats. They are for abortion. They not pro-life. You ain't pro-life. It's only the Christ life. In this world, ye shall have tribulation. You call yourself a believer. You call yourself a believer. You call yourself what you want to call. You know what I call you? I call you a politician. You better get you a mirror. You better look in it with your political self. You talk it. You talk it. You talk it. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today. It was a time you didn't talk it. But you talk it now. You the most wisest, wisdomic person for giving political advice. Walk in wisdom towards them that are without. Redeem. You ain't redeeming no time. Look in the mirror at yourself.
You need to, you know what you need to do? You need to start writing down the words that you say every day. You need to get you a blank tablet. You need to keep a tab. And every time you open your mouth to speak, you ought to write down what you write every day and watch your conversation. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Be not carried about with diverse and strange doctrines. For it is a good thing that the heart be established with grace, not with meats which have not profited them that have occupied therein. Yeah, meat. Yeah, y'all. Yeah, meat. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, that conversation. That conversation, y'all like. Yeah, I know what you, Yeah, get off my Facebook page. I ain't here to play with you because the day is getting short. And you know, regardless of what Pastor Red say in front of this camera, you know your life. You know very well how you living. You know very well your conversation. You know it very well. Yes, you do. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. All things are of God, who is love. So all things are of love. What is the problem with God? He is love. That is the problem we have with God. He is love. Jesus says, be ye perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect. Always loving, always administering grace, always giving grace to the hearers. Long suffering to us, would not willing that any should perish, but that all would come to repentance. But not you, though. You too busy judging. All things of God, who have reconciled us to himself. God has brought us back to himself by Jesus Christ and have given us the ministry of reconciliation, not division. To wit, that God, that love was in Christ, reconciling the world unto him. God's trying to bring everything back into love, not imputing their trespasses unto them, and have committed unto us the word of reconciliation, not the word of judging, not the word of hatred. There is therefore now no condemnation, Romans 8, 1 through 3, to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. You know what that means, walking not after the flesh, but after the Spirit? Colossians 4 and 5. Walking in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. Walking after the Spirit means walking in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. We're playing with God. We play with God. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, love, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, for hatred, for judging, condemned that very life, that very nature in the flesh. For love, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish when tribulation shows up, but have everlasting life. What is everlasting life? It is love. God is life. Life and love
are the same words in the spirit. God is looking for dead men who will manifest everlasting life. God's life is a life of love. God said that he gave his only begotten, whosoever believes should not perish but have everlasting life. For God, for love, sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved, because he knows that in this world we're going to have tribulations that's going to cause us to perish in the sin nature that Adam passed on to all of us. And you're going to look in the mirror when yours manifests itself. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned. Now, really, because you think you can walk towards them that are without, outside of wisdom. He that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed. I know you ain't gonna believe what I'm saying tonight. I know you ain't. Because you have not believed in the only begotten Son of God, who was the pure manifestation of what love looks like. No greater love than this, than that a man laid down his life for a friend. And this is a condemnation. That light, see there it is, it always goes, that light is come into the world. God has come into the world where there is a bunch of tribulation. Brother Peachy, but men continue to love the darkness of this world rather than God and his son and his word. And the reason is because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil, I told you earlier, we human beings are nothing but evil creatures. Oh, Pastor Red can be very evil when he wants to be. Oh, yes, he can. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light. That's why y'all hate this message. I know some of y'all hate this message. Neither cometh to the light. I hope I'm lying. But you know what? I hope I'm lying, But you know because your mirror will tell you if you're going to do what Colossians 4:5 says. Your mirror will tell you if you're going to walk in wisdom towards them that are without light. Or are you going to walk in the darkness with them? For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest their deeds should be reproved by the mirror that they're looking into. Don't look at Pastor Red. Don't look at these words. Get you a mirror. Look at you. You know how you're living. You know. Watch this. You know exactly. What the conversation between you and God is going to be when you stand at the judgment seat of Christ. You already know what he's going to ask you, what he's going to say, when he's going to ask, why didn't you walk in the light? Why you knew this light? You heard this light. Pastor Red preached this light. Why did you not walk in that? Why did you stay so political? Why did you stay so black? Why did you stay so white?
Why did you stay so Masonic? Why did you stay so sorority? Why did you stay that? Why did you stay that? Why did you stay so racist? Why did you stay so nasty? Why did you stay so unforgiving? Why? I'm telling you, do not sit up here and fool yourself. You know exactly what the conversation between you and God is going to be. You know it already. But you still got breath in your lungs. And because you got breath in your lungs, you can begin to live Colossians 4 and 5. You can begin to walk in wisdom towards them that are without and begin to redeem the time and start living in the love of God and start manifesting everlasting love towards them that are without. This know, 2 Timothy 3, 1-5, this know that in the last day, we're in the last days. Look what it's, I'm telling you, these verses I took out of the King James Version Bible, 1645. My King James Version Bible is the King James Version 1645. So if this Bible was written in 1645, how long ago was it that Paul wrote this to 2 Timothy before the Bible was even put together in 1645? This no. Also, that in the last days, perilous time. If you think perilous times ain't here, I don't know where you've been living. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection. Oh yeah, that shooting a man in the back 7 times, that is no natural affection. Truth breakers. You lie to a person. No, you know you're lying to the person. Got that person thinking you telling them the truth. False accusers talking. You talk stuff about people that ain't true. You heard it from somebody because you won't walk in wisdom towards them that are without. You walk with them. A false accuser. Incontinent. You won't stay the same yesterday, today, and forever. You sporadic. Fierce, very mean person you are. Despises of those that are good. Hate Pastor Red for the way he teaches. Hate Pastor Red because he won't support them stupid movements y'all support. Hate Pastor Red because he won't support your political affiliation. Traitors. Heady. High-minded. You think you're so much better than other people. Lovers of pleasures more than lovers of love. Having a form of godliness, having a form of love, but denying the powers thereof from such. This is what Paul is saying. From such, turn away. Colossians 4 and 5. Walk in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time that you've spent being one of these. We need to redeem that time. Watch this. God loves us. God always loving.
God, the children of Israel was in bondage for 400 years to Pharaoh, which Egypt represented the world. The children of God represented those that should have been walking in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. The children of Israel represented the people of God. Exodus 16:2-3, and the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. Now the question is, who in the world was Moses and Aaron? Moses and Aaron were those that were doing Colossians 4 and 5. They were walking in wisdom towards them that was without. And these professing people that God had chosen had brought them out of bondage, had brought them out of the world of tribulation, brought them out. And they murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. Because right now, what the media is showing us the wilderness. And I'm gonna tell you, and those that are without, we're in the wilderness with them. But is your conversation the same as their conversation? They murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. And the children of Israel said unto them, would to God, would to love, what love brought us out of Egypt when we would have died by the hand, would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land. Would to God we had died by the hand. That's us. Would to God that we died by the hand of the Lord, because Jesus Christ is our Lord. They said, would to love that we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, in this world, in the United States. I'm a black man in the United States. Would to God I'm going to die by the hand of the Lord in the United States, and I'm serving the Lord. When we sat by the flesh pots, forget the fact that the world was, Pharaoh was beating them down. All they was focusing on was the flesh pots. And when we did eat bread to the full, for ye have brought us forth into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. You know what they said? They said Moses and Aaron brought them there. If I remember right, I do not think that there was Moses and Aaron that departed the Red Sea. Nor do I believe that it was Moses and Aaron that carried them through the Red Sea. I honestly believe that God opened the Red Sea and then they walked in wisdom towards the wilderness on their own. Did you come into Christianity on your own? Did you come into the Christ life on your own? And now you murmuring over political mess. Now you're murmuring over the things that's happening in the world that Jesus says, in this world you're going to have tribulation. And when all you're supposed to do is stay in him, because he has overcome this world. All you got to do is just stay in the everlasting love of God. That's the problem of God. He don't know how to stop loving, because that is all he is. Oh, would to God we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land of Egypt, when we sat by the flesh pots and when we did eat bread to the full. For ye have brought us into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Verse 11 through 13. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying,
I've heard the murmurings. I've heard the murmurings of the children of Israel. I hear the murmurings of them people that say they saved, sanctified, and Holy Ghost filled. I can hear them murmuring. I can hear they murmuring. God bless you, Sister Selena. I love you. Oh, I can hear they murmuring.
Speak unto them, saying, at even ye shall eat flesh, and in the morning ye shall be filled with bread. And ye shall know that I am the Lord your God. And it came to pass that at even the quails came up and covered the camp. And in the morning the dew lay round about the host. And when the dew that lay was gone up, behold, upon the face of the wilderness, there lay a small round thing, as small as the hoarfrost on the ground. And when the children of Israel saw it, they said one to another, it is manna. Oh, you are right, Sister Selena. You ain't never late. And when the children of Israel saw it, they said one to another, it is manna. For they wist not what it was. See, that's the problem. See, God do stuff for us, you know, that we give it a name for that, you know, because we don't know what it is. It's love. It's love. You want me to tell you what it is? It's love. Every time you missing something and you receive it, that's love. You know, don't call it a net. Call it love. Don't call it manna. Call it love. Don't call it a blessing. Call it love. You can call it a love offering. Because that's what it is. It's a love offering. God gives us every day a love offering. It's called the breath of life. And we take this breath of life, and rather than blessing him with it, we murmur and complain with it. For they wist not what it was, and Moses said unto them, this is the bread which the Lord hath given you to eat. God ain't gave you nothing to eat, that the only thing that you can talk about is what's going on in the world. Is that what? God ain't gave you nothing to eat, that all you can talk about is what's going on in this world. Exodus 16:31. And the house of Israel called the name thereof manna. And it was like coriander seed white, and the taste of it was like wafers made with honey. So, now we do our stupid little communions, and we get them dumb little white wafers, and you know, a little bit of white thing that look like the size of a dime, a little bit bigger than a dime. We put it in, we get our little wine and we get our little wafers, and Jesus broke bread, didn't say nothing about it. He broke nothing that looked, we always wanna see stuff. The Catholics, they come around with their little thing and they got their little white round wafers in there, and because everybody's trying to duplicate what God did. failing to realize that when Joshua and them crossed the Jordan into the promised land, the manna stopped. But you know, not for us. We done made them little wafers. We done brought them all the way into 2020. The Catholics did, the dumb evangelical churches. We done jumped on the bandwagon too. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Walk in wisdom towards them that are without, redeeming the time. Numbers 21. And the people spake against God, against love. They was complaining because they didn't have nothing to eat. So God sent them quail, and then God gave them manna. But you know what? Y'all get tired of what God's giving. We're not thankful for what love gives us. If God give you nothing but perfect health and breath every morning, I tell you, the obituary will tell you somebody didn't get it. If you go to the doctor and you get a good health report, and that doctor didn't tell you you got cancer or leukemia or something, God then gave you love. And the people spake against love and against Moses. Wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread. But what did you just call manna then? What did you just call manna? Neither is there any water. What's this? This the part right here. They say there is no bread. Then they say, our soul loatheth this light bread. Our soul, they changed it from manna, and they, our soul loatheth this light bread. Our soul is disgusted with this bread that you've given us. I'm disgusted with the way black people getting treated. I'm disgusted with the way Donald Trump is behaving as our president. I'm disgusted with Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats. I'm disgusted. Walk in wisdom towards them that are without. Why are you doing that? You loathe things. Get your mirror. You know exactly what you and God are going to be talking about when you stand before the judgment seat of Christ. You can redeem that time now. You can repent and you can stop walking outside of wisdom towards them that are without, and start walking in wisdom towards them that are without. Our soul loathed this manna. I'm tired of what you're giving me, God. Gave it to him every day. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of seeing the way the black people are getting treated. I'm tired of, I ain't playing another basketball. I'm boycotting the basketball season. I'm boycotting football. I'm boycotting. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people. What the people he delivered out of the world. But you know what though? You'll see them. You'll see them. They'll be asking the body of Christ to pray for them. You know what the first thing we'll do? we'll jump on Facebook and we'll throw our stupid praying hands thing up, praying. That's what y'all do. I'm trying to tell you. I'm telling you. Your prayers ain't gonna help. Our prayers ain't gonna help. But we finna find out what'll help though. What'll help them. The Bible says to pray for them that despitefully use you and persecute you. Let's see if Moses prayed for these people. Because you know Moses, you can pray all you want. But you gotta get instruction from God as to how to deal with people that loathe what God has given them. Our soul loatheth this light bread. And the Lord set fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and much people of Israel died. So the ones that ain't dying, them, the fiery serpents biting them. So don't think, see, much people of Israel died. Well, not all the ones that was bitten by the fiery serpents died, but it was some that got bit. Oh, but the grace of God. Oh, the love of God. Therefore, the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned." But you know, but you won't look in your mirror. You won't look in your mirror and examine yourself. You're gonna keep talking that political party mess. You're gonna keep talking that Black Lives Matter mess. You're gonna keep talking that Masonic sorority Phi Kappa Phi mess. You're gonna keep talking that civil rights mess. You're gonna keep talking that racism mess. You're gonna keep living that unforgiving life mess. You're not gonna say, "We have sinned, for we have spoken against the Lord." Who is the Lord? Wisdom. They stop walking in wisdom towards them that are without. They stop walking in wisdom. "We have sinned against the Lord and against thee. Pray unto the Lord that he take away the serpents from us." See, that's the thing. You throw up them praying hands. I'm not going to pray for you. I'm going to pray that the Lord take away the serpents. God, you got believers out there trapped in this political mess, trapped in this Black Lives Matter movement mess, trapped in this racism mess, trapped in this sorority groups, trapped in this Masonic Eastern Star mess. Oh God, deliver them from those, from that mindset. See, Moses prayed for the people. I pray for the people. I pray for the people. And then the Lord said unto Moses, "Make thee a fiery serpent and set it upon a pole." You know. "And it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten..." See, have you been walking towards them that are without, outside of wisdom? You're going to get bit. Because you're in the world where you shall have tribulation. Because if the word says that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, then I tell you, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. You're going to feel the heat of it. Yes, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego felt the heat of the fiery furnace, but the heat from the fiery furnace never kindled upon them. Yes, Daniel felt the hair of the lions in the lion's den. Yes, Daniel smelt the funk, the stinkiness of the hair on the lions in the lion's den. Yes, he probably sat in the midst of the dung that they let out while he was in the lion's den, but he never felt the wrath of the lion in the lion's den. Make thee a fiery serpent, put it upon a pole, and it shall come to pass that everyone that is bitten, when he looketh upon it, shall live. And Moses made a serpent of brass, but God made his son to be sin for us who knew no sin. Moses made a serpent of brass and put it upon a pole, and it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent, he lived. Will you look to the cross and stop looking at Sean Hannity? Will you look to the cross and stop looking at O'Reilly? Will you look to the cross and stop looking at Rachel Maddow? Will you look to the cross and stop looking at Don Lemon? Will you look to the cross? Will you look to the cross? This is 2020, the year of love. You can be in denial all you want, but I tell you, if love has not been tested in 2020, this year, if your love ain't been tested, then I'm telling you, I don't know where you've been at, because love is being tested this year. Love is being tested this year. But Brother Peachy, we got an answer for love. We got an answer for it already. We already got an answer for it, Brother Peachy. We got an answer for it already. People say they know him. People say they in him. People say they got a relationship with him. He is God manifest in the flesh.
Father, help your children, and don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in your heart. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down,
so don't load nothing.
And I know He's love.
I hope you have not been loathing
forever. Ah, in my heart,
we got to walk on.
We got to walk on. Walk on through temptation, 'cause He is
Colossians 4 and 5. Walk in wisdom towards them that are without. lift up our heart and be thankful. Don't murmur. Don't murmur. Be glad. Be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. He will not.
He won't let you down.
Oh.
And I know.
Exactly that. Oh, come on now. Come on now. You got to grab and hold him. 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 Don't let this love.
Don't let this love
pass you by. Everything that you need is in the hand of the Master, Savior, Creator. His name is Jesus. Oh, Jesus, the one name you need to know. And when you meet him, just grab and hold. Don't let this peace pass you by. From every burden that you bear, there is still room round the altar. Lay them down. Leave him there, right there with Jesus.
Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus.
He can handle, he can handle your load.
So when you meet
that the world is putting on us, just grab and hold.
My brother, my sister, bless his name.
God, love will,
love will lift you up and love you as his
Tell you, God is looking for dead men. Men who manifest everlasting love. You can manifest it if you grab and hold on to it. In a world that we were told was going to be filled with a bunch of tribulations. But he says to be of good cheer, for I have overcome that world. Stay in the Christ life. Stay in the ark. Noah and them seven souls with him, they was in that ark. It was stinking in there. It was hot in there. It was probably a lot of hard times in there. But the water never made it in there. And one day, the dove didn't return with a branch in his mouth. And then the next time he sent the dove out, the dove didn't return. And Noah knew that the water had receded. But why? Because he knew that the dove wasn't dead. Because the dove was in the ark. And Moses released. The dove wasn't stupid. If the waters had not receded, the dove wasn't stupid. The dove made its way back to the ark. Oh, but when the water had receded, that dove was like, we're through the tribulation. The dove was smart enough to know it was through the tribulation. That's a shame. That the believers of God don't know how to stay in the ark. And when they leave out of the ark, that they're supposed to know that they are supposed to walk in wisdom towards them that are without. Very wise dove to return back to.
the ark, not us. We get out there and we get in that conversation with them. We join forces with them. And because of that, you never make it back into the life that enables you to manifest the everlasting love of God towards fallen mankind. But you call yourself a Christian. You call yourself a child of God. But you talk more political than you do spiritual. You talk more division than you do love. You need to shut up. My name is Pastor Red, Christ Our Life Ministries, here in Augusta, Georgia. There's a bunch of other pastors out there. Feel free to listen to them if you don't like this word I'm bringing. But you're going to wish you heard this word when you stand before that judgment seat of Christ, because you know exactly the conversation that you and the Lord are going to have about the life you lived down here as you walked towards them that were without. And he knows if you took him with you or not. He knows that. Oh, in the name of Jesus, I love you. I will see you Sunday at 10 a.m., God willing. God bless you. Amen and amen.